Welcome back. So our story that we're going to share today is titled The Carpenter's Gift, and it's a Christmas tale about the Rockefeller Center Christmas tree. So let's go ahead and see what the story is all about. Nearly a lifetime had passed, but Henry could still remember what it felt like to wake up in an old shack, especially during winter time. In those days, the Great Depression gripped the country, and like many people, Henry's parents were out of work. They couldn't afford coal for the stove or warm blankets for the beds, so young Henry usually woke up with a shiver. But he didn't complain, because it was nobody's fault. Instead, he visited warm places in his mind. One day in 1931, actually the day before Christmas, Henry was reading a book when he heard the loud toot toot of a car horn. He opened the front door and saw his father behind the wheel of a borrowed truck. "Go for a ride, Sparky?" his father shouted over the rumbling engine. "You bet," Henry shouted back. He raced inside to get his coat. Riding in any sort of car was a special treat for Henry, not to be missed. Soon he was sitting beside his father, nose pressed to the window glass. They drove into a nearby grove of evergreens. Henry breathed in the strong, familiar smell. "Here's the plan," Henry's father said. "See those spruce trees, Sparky? We're going to cut them down and take them to the city." "Why?" Henry asked. "To sell them as Christmas trees," his father said. Even though New York City was just an hour's drive away, Henry had never been there before. He shivered with excitement and thought of seeing all those tall buildings scraping the sky. When Henry and his father reached Midtown Manhattan, they began looking for a place to park and unload. Driving down Fifth Avenue, they found a good spot next to a construction site. "Mind if I set up here?" Henry's father asked a worker. The man looked them over. It didn't take him long to figure out that Henry's father was down on his luck. "No problem," the man said. "I'll give you a hand. My name is Frank." Then he turned around and called out, "Hey, Mikey, Polly, help me out over here." For the rest of the afternoon, Henry and his father sold trees to passersby. By the end of the day, they had earned enough money to make the trip a success. "We should be getting home now," Henry's father said, as the sun set behind a tall building. "What about the rest of the trees?" Henry asked. "I thought we'd give them to Frank and the other fellows." Henry nodded in agreement. "The best presents are the ones you don't expect," he thought. Because it was Christmas Eve, the workers were having a little party. Frank and the others took the tallest of the trees that Henry and his father had given them and decorated it with whatever they could cobble together. Paper garlands, cranberries threaded onto string, and even a few shiny tin cans. Henry added an ornament of his own, made of newspaper that he folded into a star. In the background, he could hear his father talking with Frank about grown-up things, the hard times for Henry's family, and the shack in which they lived. But Henry didn't want to think about those things. He just wanted to look at the most marvelous Christmas tree he had ever seen. It had been the best day that Henry could remember, and he didn't want it to end. He stood before the decorated tree, enchanted. The street lamps had just come on, and the tin cans glittered in their light. If ever there were a magic moment, Henry thought, this is it. He decided to make a special Christmas wish. He wished that one day his family would live in a nice, warm house. After making his wish, Henry opened his eyes. His gaze fell on a pine cone laying on the ground. He picked it up and was turning it over in his hands when he felt his father's grip on his shoulder. "Time to go, Sparky," his father said. Henry stuffed the pine cone in his pocket, said goodnight to the workers, and walked with his father back to the truck. By the time they arrived home, it was well past Henry's bedtime. "You must be exhausted," his mother said, slipping off his boots. "Straight to bed with you." Shrugging off his coat, Henry felt a budge in his pocket. He took it out and looked at it, remembering the joys of the day and the magic of the tree. The next morning, Harry's parents let him sleep in late. In fact, It was well past 8 when the toot-toot of several car horns woke him. Rushing to the window, he saw 3 trucks pulling up outside. All were loaded with lumber and other building supplies. At the wheel of the first truck was Frank, and behind him were the other Rockefeller Center workers. What were they doing so far from the city on Christmas morning? Frank got out of the truck. "After you left, we got to thinking," he said. "There was all this extra wood lying around, and we had the day off. So we thought we'd drive up to see what we could do to help you with this house of yours." Frank looked the shack over, taking in its patched walls and ill-fitting windows. "I think we'll have to make a fresh start," he said. Henry's father didn't have words for the way he felt, so he simply took Frank's hand and shook it. The sound of sawing and hammering traveled far enough that Christmas morning for Henry's neighbors to wonder what was going on. A few walked over and saw the new house going up and spread the word. By mid-afternoon, a dozen more people were pitching in, and the new house took shape. Frank called Henry over. "See those boards?" he said, pointing to a stack of cedar. "We're going to use them to trim the windows, but they've got nails in them. I need you to pull the nails out." Henry moved to fetch the boards, but Frank called him back. Digging into his toolbox, he handed Henry an old claw hammer. "You'll be needing this," Frank said. By nightfall, the frame of the new house was nearly done. By week's end, it had a roof. Soon enough, it was ready for Henry and his family to move in. In the spring, Henry's parents celebrated with a potluck dinner. They invited everyone who had helped build the house. Henry was glad to see Frank again. He was ready to return the claw hammer, but Frank wouldn't take it. "You keep it, son," he said. "It may come in handy someday." After dinner, Henry sat happily in his very own room. He thought about his Christmas wish and couldn't believe it had actually come true. He knew he should do something special to express how thankful he was, and he thought long and hard about what that might be. Finally, he decided to plant the pine cone. Maybe he could be Jack from the Beanstalk story, and the pine cone could be his magic bean. Henry planted the pine cone beside the new house. In time, a seedling emerged. Henry watered it and weeded it. As time passed, both he and the tree grew tall and strong. Henry especially liked to hammer away in the shade, and he became quite a good carpenter, building many projects with his skilled hands. As Henry grew up, however, he became busy with other things. He got married, moved away, and had a family. Most summers, though, he returned to visit his parents. On lazy days, he sat beneath the tree with his son, teaching him how to build things with the old claw hammer. As he got older, Henry sometimes wondered where time went. One day he was a young boy waking up with a shiver. The next day he was an old man living alone. Not needing a big place anymore, he decided to move back into the house where he had grown up. To keep himself busy, Henry began working on the house, which was showing its age. He especially liked using the old claw hammer. Its polished handle, smooth and dark from wear, felt comfortable in his hand. One day, as Henry worked on the front porch, a man drove up to see him. The old man told Henry that he worked for Rockefeller Center and that it was his job to pick out the new Christmas tree each year. "I just love your spruce," the man said. "When I saw it from my helicopter yesterday, I knew it had to be this year's tree." Henry wasn't sure what to do. He knew that being asked was an honor, but he and his tree had been together a long time, and he was reluctant to let it go. "I know I'm asking a lot," the man said, "but if you agree, I can promise you that your tree will bring joy to millions of people." Henry thought some more. "And when the holiday season is over," the man continued, "we mill the tree and use the lumber to help a family in need to build a new home." A family in need. Suddenly, Henry felt a shiver, and the calendar in his mind flipped back to 1931, driving to New York City with his father, meeting Frank and the other workers, building the house, planting the tree. He knew what he had to do. "I've been given so much," Henry said. "I want to give something back. The tree is yours." Just before Thanksgiving, Henry received an invitation to the tree lighting. On the special day, a car picked him up and drove him all the way to Rockefeller Center, where he met the family whose new home would be built with the tree's lumber. They hugged him and thanked him many times for his generosity. Afterwards, Henry stood off to the side and watched the family's young daughter. "It's so beautiful," the girl said softly as she stared up at the enormous tree. Then something caught the child's eye. A pine cone had fallen to the ground. Picking it up, she turned it over and over in her hands before stuffing it into her pocket. If ever there was a magic moment, Henry thought, this is it. Henry walked over to the girl and they stood together, gazing at the glittering tree. Then Henry reached into his coat pocket and pulled out the old claw hammer. "Here you go, Sparky," Henry said. "You'll be needing this." So I'm going to go ahead and leave it on here so you can see some information about the first Rockefeller Christmas tree. You can see the original tree in 1931. It's not as big as it is today, but you could see that the construction workers decorated it with what they had. And on the other side, it tells you about what Habitat for Humanity is. Habitat for Humanity is a charity that builds homes for people in need. And that is the end. I hope you guys enjoyed this story, and hopefully you guys were able to see the tree lighting of the Rockefeller Christmas tree this year on TV. And that's it. Bye.